Hello children, today we are going to discuss chapter Heredity and Evolution. Introduction. A recognizable feature of human being or any other organism like height, complexion, shape of nose and chin, color of eye, hair, these all are known as characters as well as traits. The transmission of traits from parent to their offspring is called heredity. The hereditary information is present in the gametes of the parents. Thus, gametes constitute the link between one generation to the next and pass on the maternal and paternal characters or traits to the offspring. What are the variations? The difference in the characters among the individual of a species is known as variation. The offspring is never a true copy of the parents. There are many kinds of variations in human species like pre and attached earlobe, different complexions, as well as a different type of eye color, height, chin, hair color, etc. As well as nose, these all are, if we will compare one organism to another organism, then different types of variations we can see. And these all are the types as well as examples of variations. Accumulation of variation. The significance of a variation shows up only if it continues to be inherited by the offsprings from several generations. The great advantage of variation to a species is that it increases the chance of its survival in a changing conditions as well as in changing environment. Some important terms: chromosome. It is a thread-like structure in the nucleus of a cell formed of DNA which carries the gene. Gene, it is the unit of DNA on chromosome which governs the synthesis of one protein that controls a specific characteristic of an organism. Genes are actually units of heredity which transfers characteristics from parents to their offspring during reproduction. Dominant gene, the gene which decides the appearance of an organism even in the presence of an alternative contrasting gene, is known as dominant gene. It represents by only capital letter. Recessive gene, the gene which can decide the appearance of an organism only in the presence of another identical gene is called recessive gene. It is represented by the corresponding small letter. Genotype, it is the description of genes present in organism. Phenotype, it is a characteristic which is visible in an organism. First filial generation or F1 generation, when two parents cross to produce offsprings, their offsprings are called first filial generation as well as F1 generation. Second filial generation or F2 generation, when the first generation offsprings cross among themselves to produce second generation offsprings, then these offsprings are known as second filial generation as well as F2 generation. Mendel's experiment. Gregor John Mendel was the first scientist who made a systematic study of a pattern of inheritance which involved the transfer of characteristics from parents to progeny. Mendel chose a pea plant for studying inheritance. Why? Because pea plant had a number of clear-cut differences which were easy to tell apart. For example, tall and dwarf pea plant. Some pea plant produced round yellow seeds while other produced wrinkled green seeds. Another reason for choosing pea plant was that they were self-pollinating. And Mendel chose pea plant only because many generations of pea plant can be produced in a comparatively short time span. And their study is much simpler as well as much easier comparative to that of animals. First law of Mendel, law of segregation. Mendel's first law of inheritance is known as law of segregation. What is this law? The characteristics or traits of an organism are determined by internal factor which occur in pair. Only one such factor can be present in a single gamete. Suppose here two plants are there, one is tall plant, another is short plant. If cross is there between both the two, then in first generation only first character is visible, that is dominating character, and this dominating character is a tallness. But in second generation, we will get both characters, tallness also as well as shortness also. Second law, law of independent assortment. Mendel's second law of inheritance or law of independent assortment states that in the inheritance of more than one pair of traits in cross simultaneously, the factors responsible for each pair of trait are distributed independently to the gametes. Transmission of traits. This is the characteristics or traits of a parent are transmitted to their offspring through gene present on their chromosome during the process of only sexual reproduction. Gene work in pair. For every trait, there is a pair of gene. One is dominant, another is recessive. Each parent possesses only one of the two genes of the pair for each characteristic. Though the offspring inherits two genes for each trait from its parent, but the trait shown by the offspring depends on which inherited gene is dominant out of two. What are genes? When a male gamete fuses with female gamete during the fertilization, they make a new cell that is known as zygote with a full of set of genes. The zygote grows and develops to form a new organism having characteristics from both the parent, which it has inherited through gene. And this gene is a unit of inheritance. The two genes are responsible for particular characteristics are always present on the corresponding position of the pair of chromosomes. Blood groups. Person has one of the four blood groups A, B, O and AB. A and B are co-dominant gene, whereas O is a recessive gene. Here I means alleles. So the gene of blood group are denoted by a IA. A is a superscript and IB. I is a allele. If genotype is IAIA or IAIO, then the blood group of a person is A. If genotype is IBIB or IBO, then the blood group is B. If genotype is IO and IO, then the blood group of an organism is O. Sex determination is the process by which sex of a person is determined. The chromosome which determine the sex of person are known as sex chromosomes. Sex chromosomes in the male is XY, whereas in female in XX. If a sperm carrying X chromosome fertilizes with ovum, then the child will be baby girl. If sperm carrying Y chromosome fertilizes with an ovum, then the child will be baby boy. It is the sperm which determines the sex of a offspring. Acquired and inherited traits. A traits of an organism which is not inherited but develops in response to the environment is called acquired traits. Acquired trait cannot be possessed passed on the future generation. For example, knowledge of doing something or any characteristic which was caused due to environmental factor and is not present by birth. So acquired characters will not transfer from one generation to another generation. These characters will develop only because of the environmental conditions. Inherited traits. A traits of an organism which is caused by A change in its DNA or gene is called an inherited trait. These are the characteristics which we receive from our parents. Only these traits can be transmitted to future generation. For example, color of eye, color of skin, complexion, etc. Evolution. Evolution is the sequence of the gradual changes which take place in the primitive organism over millions of years, in which new species are produced. The more characteristics of a species have in common and the more closely they will be related. Some important sources which provide evidence for the evolution like homologous organ, analogous organ, vestigial organ, as well as fossils. Archaeopteryx is the example of the fossils, and it is a connective link between the birds and the reptiles. Homologous organ. Organs which have some same fundamental structures, same structures, but different in functions. That type of organs are known as homologous organ. For example, wings of bird and hands of human. So in the homologous organ, same structure, different function. In analogous organ, organs which have similar functions but different in their structure. Same function and different structure. For example, wings of insect and wings of birds. Vestigial organ means organs which are non-functional in the present day forms but were functional in the ancestors, like appendix and wisdom tooth. Fossils, the remains of dead animal or plant that lived in the remote past are known as fossils. Fossils are obtained by digging into the earth. The age of fossil are estimated by the relative method or carbon dating method. There are various kinds of fossils. Some important fossils are ammonite, trilobite, and dinosaurs. What is Darwin's theory? Darwin's theory can be described as follows. Within any population, there is a natural variation. Some individuals have more favorable variations than others. Even though all species produce a large number of offsprings, populations remain fairly constant naturally. This is due to the struggle between the members of the same species and different species for food, space, and shelter. The struggle for survival within population eliminates the unfit individuals which are not able to survive. Nature will eliminate that. The fit individuals possessing favorable variations survive and reproduce. This is called natural selection. The individuals having favorable variations pass on these variations to their progeny from generation to generation. And these variations, when accumulate over a long period of time, then lead to the origin of new species. Natural selection is a process of evolution of a species whereby characteristics which help individual organisms to survive and reproduce are passed to their offsprings, and those characters which do not help will not pass on. Though Darwin theory was widely accepted, but it was criticized on the ground that it could not explain how variations arise. With the progress of genetics, the source of variation was explained by the gene. Gene vary in the natural population, and genetic variation is the raw material for the evolution. So Darwin's theory was modified accordingly, and nowadays the most acceptable theory of evolution is the synthetic theory of evolution, which is only the modification of Darwin's theory, in which the origin of species is based on both genetic variation also and natural selection also. In this case, in the case of giraffe, ancestors have short neck, but according to need as well as according to the environmental condition, the use of this organ is much more comparative to others. So only development is there in the neck. And now present, if we will see, then in the present species of the giraffe, they have a long neck. Why? Only because of the need and because of the requirement. What is speciation? A species is a population of organisms consisting of similar individuals which can breed together or produce fertile offspring. The process by which new species develop from existing species is known as speciation. Some important factors are there which lead to the formation of new species, like geographical isolation of a population, which lead to the reproductive isolation due to which there is no flow of gene between the separated group of population. Genetic drift due to the drastic change in the frequencies of particular gene by chance alone. Variations caused in individuals due to the natural selection also. Evolution of eye. Eye is a complicated organ which cannot be generated by a single DNA chain. The complex body organ of animals such as eye have been created in stage over many generations. First of all, the basic eye, like that of a flatworm, which are simple eye spot and which can detect only light. After this, more and more complex eye were evolved in many organisms. The structure of eye in each organism is different, and this is the example of the evolution of stage. Evolution of feathers. Sometimes an evolutionary change is produced in an organism for one purpose. Later on becomes more useful in other functions also. For example, bird evolved feathers as the means of providing insulation to their body in the cold weather. But later on, these feathers become more useful for the purpose of flying. Even some dinosaurs had feather, though they could not fly using a feather. Birds, however, adopted feathers for flying. So the presence of feather on bird tell us that bird are closely related with dinosaurs. Evolution by artificial selection. Different looking organism can be created from the same basic design of the ancestors. This is the known as evolution by artificial selection. For example, cabbage, broccoli, cauliflower, kohlrabi, kale can be modified artificially from wild cabbage. When farmer wanted very short distance between the leaves of the wild cabbage, the common variety is the cabbage was evolved. When farmer wanted arrested flower, development of the wild cabbage broccoli was there. When farmer wanted sterile flower of wild cabbage, cauliflower is there. When farmer wanted swollen part of wild cabbage, kohlrabi was evolved. When farmer wanted to grow large leaves of wild cabbage, Kelly was there. Evolution is not a progress. There is no real progress in the concept of evolution. Evolution is just the production of diversity of life from in different forms and in different shapes of this diversity by only because of environmental conditions. The only progress in the evolution is that more and more complex organisms have emerged over ages. It is the common belief that chimpanzee are the ancestor of human being, but this is not true. Actually, both chimpanzee and human being had a common ancestors long time ago. human evolution. Human evolution has been studied using various tools of tracing evolutionary relationship like excavating, carbon dating, studying fossils, and determining DNA sequences. All human beings are a single species called Homo sapiens. It has now been established by research that the earliest member of the Homo sapien came from Africa. So, irrespective of where we have lived from past 1,000 years, we all have African roots. Origin of life. In the Darwin's theory of evolution, how life evolved from simple and more complex forms, we saw. But in Mendel's experiment, Mendel told about the mechanism of the inheritance of traits from one generation to next generation. But they didn't tell us anything about how life began on Earth in the first place. So who told about this? This was described by the scientist, that is Stanley Miller. So the Miller-Urey experiment conducted by chemist Stanley Miller and Harold Urey in 1953 and is the classical experiment on the origin of life. It established that early Earth atmosphere, as they pictured it, was capable of the producing amino acid and building blocks of life from inorganic substances. So, dear children, this is the description of the chapter, Heredity and Evolution. Thank you.